Hi, I'm Hetal, reporting live from Project Management Institute Symposium at the Intercontinental Hotel. And with me today is IR Ellias Saidin. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you. So maybe just a quick one. Being the Principal Perunding Ikatan and VP of the Institution of Engineers Malaysia, can you tell us about the state of engineers today?
Oh, okay, state of engineers. Well, engineers are not actually, you know, in society in Malaysia and at the moment. To us, sometimes we're not really rewarded.
Right.
You know, and number one. And number two, not only in monetary terms,
yeah,
but we also feel that lots of technical people, engineers, actually are missing out in management positions.
Right.
Many instances where people from other disciplines, usually chartered accountants, overtaking engineers in seniority
in
corporate corporations. Yeah, that could be one of the view that most engineers have. Yeah.
So they're not being rewarded enough, I guess, number one. And number two, they're not climbing up the ladder as quickly as they should be compared to their peers. What are the good things that are going on, though, with the state of engineers?
Good things. Wow,
engineers. Considering it's a very bad time.
I don't know. Yeah, the very bad times. Because I was also going to add that even young people now, in the universities are staying away from engineering, not only universities. Even in school, we have surveys which shows that less students are going into mainstream science classes.
Right.
You know, we used to have science streams and
yes,
art streams. Schools, for example, used to have four classes of science students, are down to two.
Okay.
So those are not so good news. Well, the good news is...
Yes, let's get to the good news.
That's the good news. I'm thinking very hard now, the good news. Well, our numbers are increasing all the time.
Okay.
We look ahead to having a nice... bigger numbers when you look at a developed nation. Later
Sorry, you were saying that the numbers in school is decreasing. So what numbers are increasing?
Well, I mean, total. In total, yeah.
In total.
The registration of engineers, for example, are always always adding up.
Okay. So for the engineers, the aspiring young ones who are thinking about their career choices, why should they be in engineering?
Okay, why they should be an engineer? You know, engineering training has been shown to be a very good course of undertaking.
It is. I heard that 30% of the CEOs have background in engineering. That's what I heard.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. And I was going the other way around. In Singapore, they have a very high figures.
Okay.
Singapore, in fact, at the recent Institution of Engineers in Singapore, I think they are 50 years old.
Yeah.
And the Prime Minister was there,
yes,
and he actually praised the engineers in Singapore. They were, a lot of them were builders in during the Singapore expansion, and also in the government. There are lots of engineers, people with engineering background. We have engineering background people in our country as well. I have feedback from young children, you know, friends of my children, my daughter. For example, the Bank Negara.
Yeah.
They like to recruit engineers for their project officer section.
Right.
Because their engineers are so quick in taking up new concepts, even financial concepts, you know, they're very good. So the actual training, actual training of engineers is actually good for the human mind, young people. But the rest, what you do later on, of course, you see lots of people saying, oh, engineers, they're in the back room boys kind of thing. You know, they're quite straight and, not very creative and those. But like you said, a lot of them also having admitted that I know a few corporate figures in Malaysia who have engineering background, actually.
Right. So if you want to be a good corporate figure in Malaysia, then take up engineering, I guess. So the next one would be, what is the biggest skill gap in engineers that you see today? So what makes an excellent engineer, but we don't see enough of that happening because of a lack of skill?
Sure. Malaysia is a complaint going around, is always, which we are also looking into studies now, is the capabilities or the education system of engineering. There are lots of graduates, especially fresh graduates, when we get the feedback from industry, is they're not so versatile.
Right.
You know, they don't communicate so well.
Okay.
And this is one of the weaknesses. So
communication is definitely one of them.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it. There's still a lot more that we want to hear from you for, but we have limited time. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.